What is going on, Trash Talkers? We're back with another episode for you. Today's video, we're going to go over our starts and sits for fantasy football week 9 in the NFL. All that and much more coming your way right now. Hey Trash Talkers, over 85% of you are still not subscribed to the channel. Please be sure to hit that red subscribe button and turn on notifications as it will help us create more daily content for you. Thank you and enjoy today's video. All right, Nick, week 9 is here and we have a lot of great games going on today. A lot to look forward to, but before the games get started, have to get our fantasy football lineups in order. So, let's go through our starts and sits, and Nick, I'm going to start off with you like we do every week. Give us your start and sit for the quarterback position for week 9.
Yeah, so for my start of the week, I'm going bold. I'm going big. I like Jordan Love. I think this is a great matchup for Jordan Love to make his first start. The Kansas City defense is miserable. Davante Adams is back, and we saw last week Mike White, a quarterback that has no tape on him. Guess what? Blows off for 400 yards. Jordan Love, it has the legs to do it. He has the arm to do it. He's got Davante and Aaron, all these guys. I think this is an outstanding matchup for Jordan Love, and I think that he's going to be incredible for fantasy this week. And then for my sit, going once again with Baker Mayfield going up against the Cincinnati Bengals last week. He had a bad performance. He threw the ball a ton, but it really didn't lead to anything major. They faced the Pittsburgh Steelers, and it was a fairly low-scoring game. I think that it's going to be the same thing, another division rival, and the Cincinnati Bengals are a much better team than the Pittsburgh Steelers. I just think Baker Mayfield is a sit once again.
I mean, with no OBJ, obviously it seems like the Baker Mayfield-led Browns are going to be in a world of turmoil, but do you really love Jordan Love?
Love him.
Oh, I can't stand it. All right, for my start of the week, I'm going with Ryan Tannehill of the Tennessee Titans facing off against the LA Chargers in Los Angeles. Ryan Tannehill is coming off of the news that he no longer has Derrick Henry behind him. So the offense is going to run through Ryan Tannehill. More pressure, but also a lot more responsibility. Julio Jones is back. AJ Brown is still there. They are going to get this offense in working order. It's going to become a pass-first offense. This offense runs through Ryan Tannehill. He's going to have a lot of open rushing yards available to him as well. I like the start of Ryan Tannehill, but this week I'm actually sitting Derek Carr of the Las Vegas Raiders. Listen, with everything that the Raiders are going through with the Henry Ruggs situation, I have to believe that they are going to be sluggish coming out in this game. Not only that, but I believe that Derek Carr is missing his wide receiver one, and it's going to just have a ripple effect, at least for the first week. I don't think this is going to continue, but right now, their focus is so divided. They are so driven to have to go all the way across the country. On top of all the news, they're not getting a lot of sleep. They're dealing with all the emotions that have come with this. At the end of the day, I don't think Derek Carr is going to have that great of a performance. I don't think the Raiders are going to have that great of a performance. So I'm sitting Derek Carr.
All right, moving over to our running backs for the week, starting off with my start, Devontae Booker for the New York Giants against the Las Vegas Raiders. You just talked about how you don't like Derek Carr. Well, Devontae Booker is going up against this defense that has had its issues. And what I really like about Devontae Booker, besides him having the entire backfield because Saquon Barkley is out due to COVID, but Devontae Booker last week against the Kansas City Chiefs was the guy for Daniel Jones. Daniel Jones needed to get that ball out quick, and it's going to be the same thing once again with one of the best pass rushes in the NFL in the Las Vegas Raiders. This is the guy, this is the safety blanket for Daniel Jones, and he's going to get a ton of targets. I think Devontae Booker is going to turn into an absolute PPR monster this week. I think we could even see him put up Michael Carter numbers, get even close to that 14 target mark. And for my sit of the week, I have Khalil Herbert. We don't know if David Montgomery is making his return just yet, but the Bears are going up against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And last week we saw Nick Chubb, D'Ernest Johnson. They weren't able to do that much. So even if Khalil Herbert is playing and he's getting a lot of snaps, I just don't think the production is there for him. I think that the Pittsburgh Steelers have realized that they are going to have to stop the run, whether it's Justin Fields or Khalil Herbert. They don't really have to worry about the pass. So I believe Khalil Herbert, his time is up as one of the best fantasy running back options.
Devontae Booker also going against his former team in the Las Vegas Raiders. So big revenge game for him. But next up for my starts and sits, I have Myles Gaskin starting for my running back position. Now, I understand Myles Gaskin is just one of those guys where he's either hot when he's hot or he's icy cold when he's cold. They're going against the Houston Texans. The Texans have been very susceptible to the run, and I believe right now Myles Gaskin is going to have a lot of opportunity with all of the issues that they have had with Tua in the passing game. I believe that they're going to focus on the run, really establish that. That way they can build off that with the play action, and it all starts with Myles Gaskin running up the middle against this Houston Texans defense. I think he's going to have a lot of holes to run through. I like him not only through in the running game, but he is the dump off guy. He is the safety blanket for Tua Tagovailoa. I think Myles Gaskin is going to be a great start for you this week. For my sit, I'm sitting Chuba Hubbard. Chuba Hubbard has been a great replacement for Christian McCaffrey with the Panthers, and honestly not too bad since he's had to take over, but the New England Patriots are coming to town with one of the top rated rush defenses in the NFL coming along with them. You're going to see Devon Godshaw. You're going to see Christian Barmore, Lawrence Guy, all of these guys getting stuffed up front. I don't think there's going to be a lot of room to run for Chuba Hubbard. I actually expect the Panthers to be playing from behind most of this game, so the running game's just not going to be there. Sam Darnold's going to have to throw the ball to win this game, and at the end of the day, Chuba Hubbard's just not going to get the looks that you're requiring from him. I'm sitting Chuba Hubbard.
And next for our wide receivers, my start of the week, T. Higgins against the Cleveland Browns. Going back to this matchup once more, I think that we saw last week, Jamar Chase, he was taken up by a lot of the Jets defense, and we're going to see that again by the Cleveland Browns defense. T. Higgins was the leading receiver for the Bengals, and I think that his surge continues. Don't forget, he was on IR. He missed a few weeks, and so that gave Jamar Chase the chance to become that guy for Joe Burrow. But T. Higgins was that guy last year, and he's starting to grow into that role once again. I think that now that they have one more week together, getting that chemistry back together, and he's the number two option, T. Higgins is going to have some great matchups, some favorable matchups that Joe Burrow is going to take some chances with, and I really like the upside for T. Higgins this week. And for my sit, I'm going with Courtland Sutton. The Courtland Sutton has been amazing this year. He's had some incredible numbers as far as targets and receptions with Teddy Bridgewater on the field, but they're going up against the Dallas Cowboys, and I'm looking at Trayvon Diggs, the number one corner in the league, who's been mirroring wide receivers all year long, has an incredible turnover percentage. I just think that Courtland Sutton's going to be taken out of this game. They're going to have to throw to Jerry Jeudy more. They're going to have to get Albert O involved. There are other guys that are going to be the targets for Teddy Bridgewater, because Teddy is not a guy who takes any risks. He's going to look at Trayvon Diggs and say, nope, I'm not going there. I'm going to start with my number two option as my first look. And I think that's the way the entire game's going to go. Courtland Sutton is just not going to be existent in this game.
For my start wide receiver, I have Christian Kirk against the San Francisco 49ers. DeAndre Hopkins is ailed with his injuries. AJ Green looks like he's not going to be playing. Insert Christian Kirk as the wide receiver one for this team. Kyler Murray looks to be able to go for this one, so I'm trusting the passing game here. I like what Christian Kirk can do as a wide receiver one. We saw it a little bit last week when he had to fill in while DeAndre Hopkins was on the sidelines and AJ Green was being unreliable. They went to Christian Kirk and he was balling out for a little bit. Now he's going to have an entire game to do just that. I like the target share that he's going to get. I think that he's going to be well worked in the offense. And honestly, with Josh Norman being the one covering him, I think he's going to be able to outbody and outmuscle him. I like Christian Kirk in week 9. For my sit, I'm going with DJ Moore of the Carolina Panthers. I think DJ Moore is a great wide receiver, but he's being shadowed by J.C. Jackson of the New England Patriots. And if Bill Belichick knows one thing, it's to stop the best thing that you have. That is DJ Moore for the Carolina Panthers. The Panthers are going to have to rely on Robbie Anderson and Chuba Hubbard to get them through this week. And I just don't see that being a thing. DJ Moore is going to be shadowed by J.C. Jackson, a safety over the top. They're going to play double and triple coverage all around him and make Sam Darnold beat them other ways. I don't like this matchup at all. And I think DJ Moore is going to have a very slow day.
And finally, for our tight ends of the week, I'm starting off with Dallas Goedert as my start against the Los Angeles Chargers. Dallas Goedert, ever since coming back from COVID, he missed a couple weeks, but then he picked up right where he left off, and then some, thanks to Zach Ertz going to Arizona. Now Dallas Goedert being the guy at tight end for Jalen Hurts in this offense, he's been amazing. He's getting more and more receptions, more targets by the week, and I think that even though he hasn't had the touchdowns to go along with the yardage and the targets, if that comes along, that's just a bonus, because the points he's putting up right now with just yards is enough to be a top 10 tight end every week. If he gets that touchdown, he's top three easy. So I think Dallas Goedert is an amazing start against the Chargers. And then for my sit, I'm going with the big guy, Mike Gesicki. Been incredible this year, but against the Houston Texans, I think that there's better options for Tua to go to. Tua loves using his wide receivers. He loves getting the run game involved. And I think that this is where the tight end position is gonna not be the favorable matchup. He's gonna look for those guys first. Mike Gesicki is gonna be the guy left out. I don't think that with such an easy defensive matchup for this offense that they're just gonna check it down to their tight end. They're gonna go for the big plays. They're gonna go for the big run yards. I just don't think that Mike Gesicki is a part of this game plan.
For my tight ends, I'm starting Pat Freiermuth of the Pittsburgh Steelers. We're seeing that Eric Ebron is out yet again for the second straight week, and Pat Freiermuth really stepped up in his stead and honestly looked really good catching the game-winning touchdown from Big Ben Roethlisberger. Freiermuth has really showed up since entering the NFL, and with the Steelers, he hasn't had many opportunities, but what they've shown in practice and what he's shown in this offense is a command of the tight end position. The middle of the field is his, and I like where he's going to be. I think he's going to take a lot of the target share that used to go to Juju Smith-Schuster. I think he is going to be one of those guys that does a lot of the underneath stuff, gets the gritty yards. He may not have a 100-yard day, but if you can get a solid 8-catch, 70-yard day for a tight end, then you have one of the best tight ends that week, guaranteed. For my sit, though, I'm going with Kyle Pitts against the New Orleans Saints. Kyle Pitts is an incredible athlete, and I am very high on his future with the Atlanta Falcons. My issue with him is that he is now the receiver one, can't say wide receiver because he's a tight end, but essentially without Calvin Ridley, there's nobody else to key on. You're not going to key on Russell Gage. You're not going after Olamide Zaccheaus. You're going after Kyle Pitts. And if you're going to stop him, you're going to do it with Marshawn Lattimore or Malcolm Jenkins plus another corner. It's not going to be pretty. I think Kyle Pitts is going to suffer dramatically from the loss of Calvin Ridley. I think it's going to be a heavy, heavy run game with Cordarrelle Patterson and also Mike Davis. At the end of the day, I just think Kyle Pitts is not going to see the targets that he's going to command for him to start in your lineup this week. All right, well, I want to hear from you guys. Let us know in the comments down below who you plan on starting, who you plan on sitting. Let us know if you have any fantasy lineup questions. We'd be happy to help you on this Sunday afternoon. Let us know in the comments down below. All right, well, that's going to be all for now. Thank you all for watching. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Hit that notification bell. We go live every single day. That'll be all. Peace and love.